Crash rate per million miles. A customer of mine asked me, why is that so bloody important? We're going to discuss it next. Welcome to Safety Dawg EDU. All right, we're talking about crash rate and why it's so important. A customer of mine was asking me, Chris, why is this so important? Why do I have to do this? Why do I have to measure my million mile crash rate? And I simply said, look, we want to compare you to everybody else. I want to be able to compare your safety record, your crash rate, against the big boys. And I want to compare it against the little boys. I want to know how you compare. Why is this so important? A couple of reasons. You can use it to attract drivers. You can say, hey, here, this is our crash rate. Compared to the rest of the industry, we have an outstanding crash rate. Come work for us. We don't push you. That's one. Two, how about with your customers? Wouldn't it be nice to be able to say to your customers, hey, on average, we don't spill your freight all over the goddamn road like many of my competitors do nearly as often. Here's my crash rate. That is a fantastic sales opportunity for you. And I don't understand why more companies don't use crash rate to advertise and say, hey, look it, this is my thing, we're good. But anyways, it's easy to do. Here's the formula: crashes times a million divided by your mileage. Crashes times a million divided by your mileage. It is mileage. If you're a Canadian and watching this, you got to convert your kilometers to miles. It is mileage, and that's an important statement. But here, let's do an example. Four crashes times a million equals 4 million. You divide that, in this example, I'm using 2,500,000 miles, and that equals 1.6. So 1.6 crashes for every million miles traveled for this fleet, as the example. So that means, basically, every million miles, he's going to have 1.6 crashes. 1.6. The next question is that good? Is that bad? How does that compare to everybody? Let's first define what an accident is. So when you're doing this calculation, you've got to know what an accident is, because what an accident is in this calculation is not necessarily the same as what your insurance company or the police might call an accident. So under Regulation 390.5, we've got the definition of an accident. And this way, by using this calculation and these definitions, you can compare yourself to every trucking company across North America. All right, so the Regulation 390.5 says this is what an accident is. You can pause the video if you want, but I'll put a link in the show notes to this very section. But here's the highlights: a fatality, bodily injury to a person as a result receives immediate medical attention away from the scene of the crash, or a tow truck is involved. Doesn't that sound familiar? Isn't that almost the exact same definition that the drug testing program uses? Yes, but there's one major exception. There's no and a ticket in this one. All right, so anything like this is a crash. If it's a fatality, an injury with medical attention received away from the scene, or a tow truck is involved in to pull any of the vehicles away from the crash scene, that is a collision and you're counting it in this calculation. All right, so Regulation 385 tells you, is this good or bad? And let's look at that one. So again, the link will be in the show notes, but here's the highlights. If you were a city operation, so traveling within 100 miles or 160 kilometers of the center, and your accident rate, collision rate, is 1.7 or greater, it says, will be deemed to have inadequate basic safety management controls for the accident factor. So 1.7, if you do less than 100 mile radius, 1.7 is too bloody high. And if you're a long haul guy or go outside the 100 mile radius, 1.5 collisions per million miles is too bloody high. It says here, will be deemed to have inadequate basic safety management controls for the accident factor. You know that if you cross border, the SAFER system measures your accident factor. All right, so that is likely going to put you into the alert. Where did they get this number? What they did is they doubled the accident rate for years 1994, 95, and 96, doubled it on average, and came up with these numbers. So this 1.5 is double the national accident rate. That means if you're a long haul guy, the national accident rate used to be 0.75. So 3/4 of an accident for every million miles traveled was average. So if you're doing 0.75 or more, you are worse than the average trucking company. If you're doing 0.75 and less, you're better. And I know you're all striving to be better, so wouldn't that be great to use this in advertising, in recruiting of drivers, in talking to your customers? Now you've got something to compare it to. Also, because I was on the audit committee for TCA, Truckload Carriers Association, for many years, you've seen those national awards given out. Many companies have won it. Bison has won it for many years in a row. I believe it was 7 out of 10 years. They won the national achievement there. They're running well below 0.5 collisions per million miles. Well below that. All right, so that's what you got to strive for. Get it low. Less than 0.75, you're better than the average trucking company. I put a link to my website here. There's a million mile crash rate calculator I put right on the website. You're welcome to use it. The link, again, is in the show notes below. Click the link, go figure it out. Use 12 months of miles and 12 months of crashes. That's what you got to do, and you can figure out your crash rate. There's the link. Thanks very much.